heard rumors that my headset lasts up to 10 hours. Shall we find out if that's the case? So, let's go ahead and continue where we left off, because I don't like people. Specific people. You'll see what I mean. Hey, remember that guy? That was the assistant of Sir Bison. Mm-hmm. That's right. Sir Bison is in fact a Bandor spy. Who would have guessed? Use the underground waterway. You remember that place, right? On the plus side, you know, at least none of the enemies are a threat anymore. What are these enemies? Oh, right. I forgot. Yeah. So, they actually restocked the enemies in this place. Just be dicks. And yes, I actually did add in the BTP trolling intensifies into OBS, so I don't have to actually edit it in. Yay me. Oh, damn it! I hate sewer dungeons. So I've got a theory as to why everything seems so difficult for me, and that's the game assumes that you repeatedly reload, or not reload, repeatedly die, go back to town, come back into the dungeon, rinse repeat over and over and over again. It's the only explanation, because I mean the Shining games don't do this. The Shining games you can actually play through battle by battle by battle and not be underleveled at the end of the game as long as you do it right. In this case, I'm actually underleveled right now. According to the walkthrough that I just glanced at, I'm about 2 to 3 levels below the recommendation. I don't get it. Hunt leveled up! Woo! I learned Summon 3! Not the most useful of abilities. And if you're still alive, go ahead and eat an ice. Eh, sure, let's see what Summon 3's like. If they're still alive. I hope they're not, because they're going to hurt. Ow. Okay. I'm gonna be healing. So, let's see what the Summon 3 is like. I grabbed a succubus. Oh, I remember these guys! Apparently, succubi wear thongs, just for reference. Oh, I forgot to heal. Crap. Oh, well. Maybe it'll die before it can do anything. Samson is useful as always. Right. We're going to heal, damn it. Ba-ding. Yeah, I have no idea why it's just sitting there not doing anything. Let's go back through and not accidentally fall into the sewer again. hate this dungeon so much. Ah! Not what I want to see. Of course Samson's groggy. I mean, he's not cursed anymore, but that doesn't matter. Since when has that made a difference for Samson? He still sucks. Tighten it. Tighten them all! Edward. Which is unfortunate because I have a boss battle to deal with. Gonna suck. Hey, look, too rocky. Thought item. Magic. Heal rain. Yeah. Heal rain again. Alright, now we get to actually explore things. Who will just resurrect and absolutely nothing else? Well, let's go down the staircase first, because why should we actually progress blood? Especially when there's shiny treasure chests in here. Guiding branch, iron plate, which I believe is for Mkwedka. Yeah, it is. Only it's worse than what he can. I don't get it. It's not like I could have gotten here any earlier in the game. Why? I know. Right, need to click there again. Cure herb. Okay. I should heal up, because I don't believe I control anything until the boss battle. Healing herb. Wait, everybody's on max HP already, it's just MP that they're low on, right? Yeah. So, I think I have three characters that need to go drink a potion. Let's say one of these. Okay, make sure I have decent balance. Yeah, taunt hold that. Okay, so Annie's got 3 mage's potions. Finn's got 4. I should give one of these to Annie. Samson's got 4. Edward's got 4. Taunt's got 5. That should be okay. Nod. Yes, nodding. This way. Ah, good. I can't move. Everything else is locked, naturally. Now, time to turn the tables! This would be an awesome screenshot, except that there is one screenshot in particular, the one that you saw at the beginning, that I have to use. And no, that is not photoshopped. He really does say that. It is the most awesome quote ever in this game. Just making sure that everything else is locked. Yeah, it is. So, they're equivalent of an FMV sequence. They did. Right, yeah, totally executed. Standing right behind you. Sir Bison! I still say that is the best name ever. How did you... Sir Bison, what is the meaning of this? Chop, chop! What? That's impossible. There's no way to break that curse. Because, you know, I said anything at all about it to him. Ever. Hint, hint. Don't listen to these imposters, they're just trying to deceive you again! But there is no third time. Keep that in mind. Yes, your badge is... that's... yeah, good. It's that damn pillar again. Oh gods, it's that guy! Sir Pita, that's what I'm gonna call him. Glasses are great. Let's do this! Who? Ah! He's powering up. He kind of does look like a DBC character after all. Mind you, he's actually not that much stronger than Finn, so I don't know why he thinks that this is that big of a feat. But whatever. Gameplay and storyline segregation. Honk. Yeah. And now, the best lines in the game ever. Not those lines. Hey look, the first quest arc is complete! Or the second quest arc. No, this would be the first. The second one's already complete. Hi. Sob! I'm sobbing, crying. Yeah, these words aren't the ones I'm referring to. These words are the ones that I'm referring to. Dots. Yep. See, Samson actually has more IQ now, so he can pick up on things like that. Ha ha! I guess I slipped the tongue. It's all over now. The throne of Zalagoon was mine. That was the deal. Questions? You know, actually, I think yes. Yes! You are the ones who ate the pickle! Please regurgitate the pickle into this little basket. Now, of course, some would dispute the fact that I could not be in two places at once with the tiny lamp, but then again, it is the Pickle Nation that will rise up! The chickens will perish! That's right. And alas, get in the boat! Pepper! Pepper, you get over here right now and get into this boat before I slap you in the noodle! I am your daddy, and you will be the first who escapes the fire! What is this? A tiny little, so tiny, so tiny! I love you, little pill! Oh, I love you so! Let me swallow you, little friend! Together we will make history! By the way, kids, don't swallow random pills from evil overlords. It does not, in fact, relieve your suffering. It turns you into Glade. This is my kingdom! My world! You can't have it! No! He is huge! And glowing. And now he sheds his skin. That, ladies and gentlemen, is Glade. Glade is the first boss of the game, who sold his soul to demons. This is the first real boss of the game. By real boss, I mean he has lots of things that are... I must see to it to the downfall of Marion and Zalagoon. Step forward. By the way, who is Mikwedka? Who is Mikwedka indeed? I am. Just a little kid. I guess it's a simple request. Lord Chuet no longer wishes you to live. So now Lord Chuet knows my name. This is not a good sign. I'm sorry, but I must assure you here. Nothing personal. This is the first real boss of the game for one reason and one reason only. Glade has multiple actions per round. That is a hallmark of every other boss in the game. The one that I fought earlier was not that. It's kind of strange. Every other boss is, well, you'll see. Glade is not easy to deal with, by the way. Let's see. If I remember right, Glade uses a bunch of fire magic. He can also heal himself, apparently. And he's probably going to be healing rain left and right and up and down. So yeah. This is going to suck. Edward is relegated to attack duty. And I think on the first round, I think it makes sense to actually have taunt on attack duty as well. So I hit for 12. May I note that Glade has 950 hit points. Or vitality points. He also has lots of double attacks. Glade is not a very fair person to fight. Rather than heal rain, just heal yourself. Attack, attack. Do I have any items in his inventory? He's got a wind vase. This is probably the correct battle to use these items, by the way. In fact, I'm going to. Fire Drake is probably efficient for this. Annie's not going to end up doing any attacking, so I'm not going to worry about buffing her. Much better on damage. By the way, it doesn't seem like Glade's all that difficult, but that's because he hasn't started doing anything powerful yet. That is Undyne. Glade is actually weak against wind. Unfortunately, I'm not high enough level to actually have any wind spells. He's not very weak against fire, though. See, this is what he frequently does. All the time. So imagine two rounds of that every round. That is entirely possible and somewhat likely. He is on heal rain. She is on heal rain duty for the rest of the match, most likely. Attack, attack. Not sure what actually makes sense. Let's try ice one. And summon three. It's not really that much more expensive than Fire Drake, and it might do more damage. Don't know. Oh, hey, look, Fire 2 again. Luckily, I can survive two Fire 2s in a row now. Yes! That's what I want to see. Not really that great in damage. Get a Poltergeist, who just punches him in the face. That's great. Oh, hey, look, I get Fire 2'd again! I should probably just keep track of the number of rounds for attack. It's kind of more efficient that way. Blam! Okay, I'm thinking a full heal of Samson would be better in this case. Samson's my primary attack damage dealer right now. That's a phrase that I didn't get to utter for the entire rest of this game up until now. Let's see. How do you like Thunder? And how do you like Titan? I might be in trouble if I have two fire tubes, which I won't, so that's fine. Well, it dealt more damage, at least. Probably not worth using. Oh yeah, by the way, he heals. But I think that's the only time he can heal. Something like that, at least. He only healed 30, so it's not that big of a deal. Go ahead and cap us off with a heal rain. Attack, attack. Yeah, you know what? Ice to it. And Titan. McWedka with 40 HP. It's awesome. Yeah, I think from now on he'll probably just flame us to death. Which can be a problem because I actually don't heal enough to handle two of them. Regular attack. Okay. Heal rain. Attack, attack. Yeah, that'll work. Annie having MP is far more important than anything else right now. Yep, that's kind of what I expected. Up on McWedka. Actually, attack up on Samson, attack up on McWedka, because there's a chance that taunt might fall, after all. Sorry for not saying much, I don't tend to talk much when I'm actually trying to think about things. Most of this game I don't have to think much, so I can chat as much as I'd like. So this is a pretty long boss battle. Is it even worth healing that? No. Annie, do you have any attack items in your inventory? Tempest Jewel. Probably should have used that earlier, but... actually, use that on... Sammy. Attack, attack. I'm out of MP, so go ahead and... potion yourself. And, yeah, let's go ahead and do more summons. There's always a chance I might get a wind spell after all. Double attack percentage, that's what the Tempest was. Yep, don't care. Oh, actually I do care, McWedka can't handle two of those. I wish I would have realized that. Oh well. He may be unconscious for a bit. Dark Elf? With an attack. Really? I mean, it's 15 damage at least, but come on. You could have done better. Yep, McWedka's unconscious. Well, that was unfortunate timing. More unfortunate that I won't be able to heal Rain him either. This would be the correct round to do that. Ba-da-ding. Yeah, let's go ahead and heal Rain again. Attack, attack. I can spend 6 MP. Taunt, I can spend... nothing. Meh. Fire drag it. Screw it. Probably not too long for the world at this point. Can't be, right? Right? Yeah! Boink. Do we have any other nifty things in inventory? Not really, no. Mill rain. Do you have any nifty things in your inventory? Yeah, you actually have a lot of nifty things in your inventory. I wish I would have realized. Oh well, bit late now. What a surprise. Attack, attack. Okay, so have him use a mage's potion on Annie. Have Taunt use one on himself. There. Long boss battle is long. Ow. Yeah, really, Annie just uses heal rain every round. Not that there's anything wrong with that. Sadly, Glade is the type of boss that you want to just constantly beat senseless rather than use magic against, because I don't have... Oh, he's dead. Never mind. Done. Attack power reduced to normal. Booyah, Glade. Booyah, indeed. Shoot at, sir. Don't take them lightly. Herc! Death did. Well done, old chap. You must be tired. It will take a while to gather the troops. You should rest while you can. Free healing! Woohoo! Okay. But the... Taunt, why are you sleeping on top of a... So. I did not realize the item was there. At all until the last time I played through the game when I actually looked at a walkthrough. I originally had the whatchamacallit, official guide, but they didn't bother mentioning it. What that item does is that you can choose whatever song you want. Apparently Edward dreams of eating things. Samson dreams of, damn it, Samson! Annie dreams of McWedka doing something. While I was in my bed, I could have actually asked Steiner, but I forgot to. Creepy. Or what? Ah, it's a monster! Oh, right. Everybody back inside of me. There we go. Okay, is there anything else I need to worry about in here? Let's see, let's find a good music. Good music? There we go. I'll go with that. Sounds sufficiently awesome. Nope. Music goes away when you leave. Dun dun dun! And travels to Quamdar. Quamdar is the city at the edge, is actually, if I remember, the city immediately beyond the underground. Weird. Dragon's recuperation. So, when a dragon is injured, it'll always return to one place. Keep that in mind. Hint, hint. Windmill of Zalgoon. It's a collection of pictures. Right. Pictures. They're not wearing any clothes in those pictures, are they? Apparently, Zalgoon and Bandor have been at war before. Arwen's Twilight. Reeve Village Tours Incorporated. Danger underfoot. People falling into wells, like the ones everywhere in the town. So, Mithril weapons are in this game, just like they are in Shining Force 2. They are, in fact, some of the best weapons of the game. However, in this case, it's not really that... It's not random like it is in Shining Force 2. You actually get to just buy them, if I remember correctly. It's kind of nice. They're just ludicrously expensive. Yeah, well, he didn't... He claimed that I was an imposter, so he can wait, damn it. Shoot, shoot. Sir Piet! A side to attack from Marion's side. I wonder... Actually, I'm going to stop this around here, mostly because I need to use the bathroom pretty badly, and I've played enough today. Ew, it's a chamber pot. Ew. Let's see, what is down here? Oh, that's right, this is just where I came from. Whoa. That was thunder. Sweet. We're apparently having a thunderstorm. Glad I timed my shopping trip when I did. Okay, I've investigated everywhere. Might as well go do plot. Is there any solution? But how? I wonder, it's almost as though we would need a small force of very, very powerful individuals. Say, 5 of them. Some of which may be little kids. Because, you know, I'm in an RPG and the main character does everything. Crowns, plural. But I get a ring of power, which is the important part. Huh. Yeah, no. That's actually not... Oh, yeah, it is listed in the FAQ. I should go equip that, actually. Ah, comfortable? Good. Well, that's the reason why I've been stealing everything. Duh. Feminine undergarments. The king and queen live in different rooms, after all. I mean, you can't have such blasphemy like seeing both of them in the same place at the same time. Or same room at the same time, same bed even. Talk to the queen. And then talk to the king. We're trying to figure out how to do this without losing a bunch of people. But how? Apparently there is monster bait hidden in this room. There. Let's see, is there anything else? Nope. Okay, so I'm gonna stop here. Good night, everybody. I will probably continue this next weekend. Maybe during the week, probably not. Bye! And always remember, dun dun dun!